Logan, what did you do?
Charles, the world is not the same as it was. Mutants. They're gone now.
I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain, the only thing that's real.
Where is she?
Beneath the stains.
She's like you.
Of time.
Very much like you.
The feelings disappear.
She needs our help.
You are
someone to come along.
Someone has come along.
I am still right here. And you could have it all. My empire of dirt. I will let you down. I will make you hurt. I will keep myself. I would find away.
Logan, you still have time.
Movie month. It is my fourth annual movie month. I'll watch 30 movies that I've never seen in 30 days.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. It's already day two. Can you believe it? Wow, how time flies. Day two of the 2017 movie month is in the books. It's over. It's done. I just finished watching the 2017 Hugh Jackman film, Logan. And I was thinking about this. You know, Hugh Jackman has played Wolverine since the first X-Men film back in 2000. So it's been 17 years of him playing Wolverine in various movies. Sometimes it's a cameo. Sometimes he's the star of the film. Sometimes he's part of the film. And in 17 years, you know, it's like you see kind of, you know, the journey that the character has taken. And I don't know if this is the last time we'll ever see him play Wolverine again, because this is its own story. It's set in the future. So I don't know exactly what that means. But I'd have to say that Hugh Jackman's Wolverine is probably the best overall superhero portrayal, you know, ever in film. Because, I mean, just seeing the different, like, it's got to be the best performance of a superhero character. How could it not be, you know? Wolverine's not my favorite superhero character, but, you know, when you think of Wolverine, you think of Hugh Jackman. You think of Hugh Jackman, you think of Wolverine. You know, it's not the same when you think of, you know, Batman and Superman. You think of a few different guys. Even Spider-Man. You know, you think of Iron Man, you think of Tony Stark, you think of Robert Downey Jr. There's that comparison. And who knows with Wonder Woman, but that's besides the point. That's for another day. Today, it's about Logan. It's about this definitely rated R movie. It was so violent that I loved it. That seems weird to say, but it was realistic violence as much as realistic as it could be when you have people with razor knives shooting out of their hands. But they, if you have these giant, you know, knives shooting out of your hands and you have bad guys chasing you and you're going to use it on the bad guys, it's going to get pretty violent. It's going to get pretty messy. And this, I feel like, was the messiest, the most violent, and overall the best. It just felt like a realistic Wolverine movie, if that even makes sense. It was great to see Patrick Stewart again. Professor X, Mr. David, Mr. Green, I said Dr. X the other day, and turns out that, you know, that's That's a guy with a band called Queensryche. Anyway, I'm already off the rails. I love this movie. You know, it was 2 hours long. It was just, I found myself, you know, pumping my fist a few times, mainly because of the violence that this little girl actually did. She is, I mean, look, if I'm going to spoil this for you, I'm going to spoil it. You could stop listening. If you already clicked the play, or you already downloaded it, so you've done your job for me, you can stop listening anytime. It's fine if I spoil it. But obviously this little girl has the same power as Hugh Jackman, the same special ability, the same adamantium skeleton. And we come to find out that, of course, she is his daughter, you know, from his genetics that she was created in a lab. But seeing her kick ass was pretty kick ass. Seeing her, like, the reveal of her and seeing Hugh Jackman see what she actually is, very cool. And I don't know, there was so much going on in this movie. There were kids that were killed. I mean, that is a hard R. They meet this nice family. Oh, sorry, they're all dead. Oh, well, you know, you thought, oh, that's nice. Wolverine is meeting a nice family. He gets to help people. Nope, sorry, they're all dead. We also had evil Wolverine. He was a little younger. He wore a black sleeveless shirt as opposed to the white tank top that our good Logan was wearing. I don't think they had to do many digital effects. I think they just made him not look older, because Hugh Jackman doesn't look as old as Logan does. But I don't think he looks as young as this evil Wolverine, which I don't know what his name was. I don't know if he was X-24. I don't know. But the big performance obviously goes to the little girl. Her name is Daphne Keel. I don't know her from anything else. This is the first thing I've seen her in. But I'm sure you're going to see her in future things. Maybe in future X-Men movies. I don't know. But this Wolverine has always been big enough to have his own movie. And the first one, Origins, you know, really wasn't good. The second one, The Wolverine, was better. But Logan was just great. Was done right, done well, and well done. I am not a film reviewer, but I have to say that I watched this movie. That's really what it comes down to. I rented this through Google, watched it on my Roku, watched it on my television, and I'm very pleased that this was the second movie I chose. I'm a sucker for these movies where groups of kids get together and adventure awaits, going all the way back to Goonies. And there's a little bit of that in this movie, and who knows if we'll see something like that in the future. At some point, there's these other kids, and they all get together, and they use their powers, and you're like, yes, yes. It was the unslick version of X-Men First Class. This was more raw, more violent. And even the main villain guy, he was good. His name is like Roy Holbrook or Rory Holbrook or something. But if you watch Netflix Narcos, he's like the main American cop in that. A main DEA agent. And you like him in that, and you hate him in this. So he does a good job. And, you know, old Patrick Stewart. And then there was this albino guy. I can't think of his name, but he was in the British Office, and he was in some other things. You'd recognize him probably if you watch, you know, if you're a watcher of television. He was good. And just, I said that family they met, it was Eric LaSalle from ER. I haven't seen him in years. And there was a kid that I recognized. He was on the Goldbergs. He played the son. And, you know, evil Wolverine wiped them all out. He wiped out Patrick Stewart too. So the final scene, there was no after credit scene. Again, I'm spoiling it. I don't care. There was no after credit scene because this was the end of, you know, the end of the line for this story, I don't want to spoil it, but for Logan, and the final scene where little Laura takes a cross and turns it into an X, I had a feeling that was going to happen. I thought it was a perfect ending. And I teared up a little. I did tear up a little. I'm not going to lie. It got to me just a little bit, but look, I'm a sucker for anything. If someone cries on a TV show, I'm going to start watering up. It could be like, I wouldn't say a reality show. That's the only time. When people cry on reality shows, I laugh at them. And people, when actors cry, like for character's sake, I do tear up. And that happened a little bit in Logan. I'm not going to lie. I am not going to lie. My cousin had a son last year and named him Logan. And there's a great picture of my cousin and his baby boy. And he's looking up at his dad. And I took it because they wanted me to do something with it, him and his wife. And I took that picture because she had a little fist. And I put the adamantium claws coming out. I gave him the Wolverine sideburns. And I added a little X-Men wristband on him, like he was basically about to attack his dad. And they loved it. And my aunt, who was the grandmother, hated it. And I thought it was hilarious. She's like, what is this? This is awful. And everyone else loved it. And I put it on Facebook, or they put it on Facebook. But that was a lot of fun. I also wanted to say, I love, and they've done this before, I'm almost positive. I love the idea that the X-Men became like such a legendary story that they created comic books and toys in the X-Men universe. So, you know, there's moments of comic book in this story. There's references to a Wolverine toys. And it's to me, I think that's cool because it's almost like, you know, say if a superhero came out in real life here, you'd think people would start to tell stories and merchandise on things because everyone wants to merchandise something. So I just thought that was pretty cool. The whole overall movie was just awesome. I highly recommend it. And really, I have nothing else to say about Logan except awesome, awesome, awesome. Definitely got, you know, earned the rated R, and definitely something I would watch again in the future. And that's it. Day two of Fans Not Experts Movie Month is in the book. We have 28 more days to go. And I have, these were the only 2 days that I knew exactly which movie it was going to be. So tomorrow, I have no idea. I have a bunch of movies ready to go. I don't know which one I want to choose. It could be something that's out on DVD or on digital. It could be something a little newer. I know I want to get to the theater soon. But don't worry, no matter what, there will be a third movie tomorrow. And until then, you can follow along with me on Instagram, on Twitter, on Facebook. Look for the hashtag FNE Movie Month. You'll find me on Twitter at Geek Mentality and at Fans Not Experts. And on Facebook, it's just facebook.com/fansnotexperts. My Instagram, I say every day, is Mikey, M-I-K-E-Y. Yes, I'm 40, and I still have friends who call me Mikey. Correa, C-O-R-R-E-I-A. That is my Instagram, and I'll be posting little links to every movie. Not links, but I'll be posting pictures from every movie that I did. The Logan one's already up. Yeah, I'm 40 years old, and I have a group of friends that if they didn't call me Mikey, it would sound weird. So, that's where I am in life. Anyway, I'm done. Thank you for listening. You should watch Logan if you did already. Obviously, you agree with me. If you don't, you know, there's something wrong with you. But if you haven't watched Logan yet, go watch it. And other than that, I mean, this is my theme song, so why don't you listen to this?
This is my podcast. I made it. Geek Mentality's what I named it. And I think you should listen and subscribe. 'Cause I'm kinda funny and awesome. I think that I'm worth your time. And I'm kinda handsome. My mom says, please listen and please subscribe. At least listen to this episode.
Fans Not Experts.